Hello everyone, welcome to lesson 72 of our Golang course. In the previous lessons, we explored the fundamental concepts of concurrency and how Go routines can be leveraged to write efficient programs. Today, we will focus on mutexes and specifically read and write mutexes. Mutexes are a crucial synchronization primitive that ensures data consistency when multiple Go routines access a shared resource. We have already covered mutexes in our previous example. Mutual exclusion, also known as mutex, is a fundamental concept in concurrent programming. It ensures that only one coroutine can access a shared resource at a time. Imagine a critical section of your code that updates a bank account balance. Without a mutex, multiple coroutines could try to modify the balance simultaneously, leading to inconsistency and errors. So, mutexes act as a gatekeeper for these critical sections. A Go routine attempting to enter a critical section protected by a mutex will first need to acquire a lock. If another Go routine is already holding that lock, the first Go routine will be blocked until the lock is released. This ensures access to the shared resource, preventing race conditions and maintaining data integrity. So all in all, in simpler terms, mutexes are like traffic lights for your code. They prevent collision by regulating access to shared resource one Go routine at a time. Mutexes in Go provide you with lock and unlock methods. These are both used to guard the shared resource. The lock method attempts to acquire a lock on a mutex. If successful, the calling Go routine gains exclusive access to the critical section. If another Go routine already holds the lock, the current Go routine will be blocked until the lock is released. The unlock method releases the locks on the mutex, allowing other waiting Go routines to acquire it and proceed. It's crucial to always call unlock after finishing with the critical section to avoid blocking other Go routines indefinitely. As such, to guarantee that the mutex is always unlocked, even in cases of errors or early exits from the critical section, it is recommended to use deferred unlock statement so that unlock is always called. I know I have talked a bit about the critical section, so let us go over the critical section in detail. The term critical section refers to a portion of your code that modifies or accesses a shared resource. Since only one Go routine can be inside a critical section, protected by mutexes at a time, it's important to keep the section as efficient as possible, and unnecessary operations within the critical section can become a bottleneck, hindering the overall performance of your concurrent program. This is where the read-write mutexes come into play. Unlike traditional mutexes, which enforce exclusive access, the read-write mutexes allow for a more granular approach to synchronization. By using read-write mutexes effectively, you can optimize access to shared resource, allowing concurrent reads while ensuring exclusive writes. This can greatly improve the performance and scalability of your Go application, especially in scenarios with frequent read operations. Now let us delve deeper into read-write mutexes. While conceptually similar to standard mutex, the read-write mutex offers greater flexibility for scenarios where reads are more frequent than writes. Unlike a mutex that enforces exclusive access, a read-write mutex provides two distinct locking mechanisms. First is the read lock or R lock. Multiple Go routines can acquire a read lock concurrently, allowing them to access the shared resource for reading purposes simultaneously. This significantly improves the performance when your application has many readers as compared to the writers. Think of it like a library where many patrons can browse bookshelves at a time. The lock method is similar to the standard mutex. A write lock provides exclusive access, modifying the shared resource. Only one Go routine can hold a write lock at a time, ensuring data consistency. This is like having a librarian update the library catalog, requiring exclusive access to prevent conflicts. So, the key advantage of read-write mutex lies in the ability to grant read access to multiple Go routines while a write lock is not held. This allows for more efficient use of resources, especially in situations where reading heavily outweighs writing. Imagine a news website with constantly updated content. Many users can read the latest article concurrently, so can hold read locks without blocking a single writer from updating the content. So just to recap, a normal mutex will lock both read and write operation when other goroutine is holding a lock, while the read-write mutex would not block any number of readers from reading the content when only a read lock is held. Let us look through a code example. Here in a code, first we have a counter struct. Inside it, we have a mutex, which is sync.writeMutex, and then a counter. Then we have a method increment on a counter, where we first hold a lock, defer an unlock statement, and increment the count value. This is a write operation. Next, we have the get operation or the read operation. As you can see, now we are using the read lock. Then we are deferring with the read unlock, returning the count. In the main function, we instantiate the counter. We have a loop creating 10 goroutines for write operation. Inside it, we are incrementing the counter. Then we have another loop for read operation. So we are writing 10 times and reading 10 times. But in here, to simulate a heavy operation, we are just doing a sleep. Let's increase the read coroutines to 100. Now in this scenario, where our read operations overweigh the write operation, read-write mutex is really helpful to increase the performance. If you remember, any other goroutine reading the counter will not interfere with the simultaneously running goroutine that's trying to read. Locks will be only blocked when we are writing to the resource. So, to summarize, read-write mutexes shine in a scenario where reading a shared resource happens significantly more often than writing it. Unlike regular mutexes, read-write mutexes allow multiple goroutines to acquire read locks concurrently. This means that readers don't have to wait for each other, significantly improving performance when dealing with many concurrent read operations. Imagine a busy classroom with textbooks. Students can access and read their books simultaneously without needing to wait for each other, assuming there is enough for everyone. To ensure data consistency, write lock and read write mutex function similar to a regular mutex. Only one goroutine can hold a write lock at a time, blocking any other goroutines attempting to read or write until the lock is released. This exclusive access prevents conflicts when modifying the shared resource, similar to how one student can write their name in a textbook at a time. This distinction between non-blocking reads and blocking writes allow read-write mutex to greatly improve concurrency and performance compared to a regular mutex in read-heavy scenarios. That's it for the lesson. I hope you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, please reach out to our Discord server or leave a comment under the video. Until next time, happy coding!